So hello everybody, I'm so happy. I'm being happy to host this wonderful concert, hopefully exquisite concert, okay? And I'm just gonna read what I wrote for you guys because I'm very nervous, you know? And plus English is not my first language, so I'm just gonna read this to you, what I wanted to say to you, okay? So we're gonna have a wonderful lineup of performers to entertain you. Today is a celebration. It's the very first recital for some students and the 10th one of the others. Our recital will showcase a wide variety of levels from beginners to advanced students. This variety gives older students the opportunity to remember what it was like to be a beginner, and younger students the chance to see what they can achieve in the future. I feel very fortunate indeed to teach such special group of students. This past year, we had 19 students complete the Arizona State Program of Piano Performance and Theory exams with wonderful results. Some students participated in Phoenix Music Teachers Association Folk Festival and Elder Competition with great success. You can hear me, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Everybody else can.
Okay.
Okay.
Sorry.
I
always wanted to do that.
Each and every child today has shown incredible growth and progress, and they should feel very proud of what they've achieved. It's not easy to come up here on stage and perform with confidence and musicality, and that's what I'm teaching them to do. So let us applaud all of our students today. So let me introduce to you my wonderful student, Penelope Vella. She's gracefully agreed to host the recital with me as my host, right? As my co-host. Penelope went to acting camp in Washington, D.C. this June. I got to see a short film that she wrote and acted in. It was wonderful. It was very impressive. Please welcome Penelope Vella. Let the show begin.
Right. Hi, everybody. Sorry, I'm not that tall. So my name is Penelope Vella, as Ms. Luba said, and I'll be your MC for the evening. Throughout the concert, I'm going to be sharing facts about J.S. Bach because many of our students are going to be playing his pieces. Now, I know everyone's probably a little bit nervous. I'm pretty nervous. It's pretty hard to go out there, like she said, with confidence and musicality. So I want to start us off with a little music joke. Why did Beethoven get rid of all his chickens?
Who said he knows it?
Because when he asked them, what are you, is your favorite composer, he said, Bach, Bach, Bach. All right, first we have my lovely brother, Marcos Vella, and Miss Luba playing a duet by Bach himself called Bardinerie. Now, our first fact for Bach was that he was born in 1685 in Germany, and his father was a seventh-generation musician, and he carried on the tradition by teaching Bach how to play the violin.
Thank you.
Up next, we have Joanna Dosri playing The Race, Hide and Seek, Singing Eagle, and An Apple by Irina Goren.
She did. She just turned six. So Penelope is going to be playing for us today a piece by Eric Satie. It's called Jimmy Petit.
Thank you.
goodbye song, Friends, Playing Ball, and a duet called When I'm Blue by Irina Corr.
He's only 5, and he's been studying with me for about 9 months only. Great results, right?
Okay, next we have up Sydney Perry playing Polonaise by J.S. Bach, Sick Doll by P.I. Tchaikovsky. Here's another fact about Bach. He lost both his parents at the age of 10, and that's why his brother taught him how to play the organ.
Thank you.
have Reno Sharma playing Doll's Funeral by P.I. Tchaikovsky and March in D Major by C.P.E. Bach.
I was just gonna mention something about, you guys might be wondering about what is the deal with the dolls, right? So Pyotr Ilyich Tchaikovsky is a Russian composer who wrote Nutcracker, and he's well known around the world. So he wrote children's album for little kids, and he wrote it, he dedicated it to his nephew, lucky nephew, right? And so the Sick Doll, it's a series of three pieces. Sick Doll, which Sini just played very beautifully. Then the second part would be the funeral of the doll, and then the new doll. So I don't have anybody playing the new doll, but Renaud's gonna be playing for us right now, funeral for the doll.
Thank you.
have Helena Cow playing March and Jazzy Lullaby by V. Ignatieff and Night Clouds by L.F. Olson. Next up, we have Kiev Daisley playing Musette by J.S. Bach and Mashed Potato Clouds by D. Hoodie.
Thank you.
Spencer Chua playing Sonatina in C major, the first movement by T. Haslinger, and Tempest by M. Bover. Given a diamond ring from the Crown Prince Frederick of Sweden, who was amazed by his playing.
Thank you.
Kandu Ngube playing The Summer Storm by W. Gillock and The Gulf Stream by C. Rowland. Visions, Fugitives, number 10, Vidi Kole Semente by S. Prokofiev.
Thank you.
Sandra Crago, playing The Crane by M. Krasev, Swans by El Garo, and Feel So Free duet by P. Dreyer.
Thank you.
playing Sonatina in F by H. Cobb, Grieving Doll by Rui Grock, and Kitten Duet by V. Kalinikova. By F. Telemann, Bagatelle by L. Chayette, and Secret Agent by D. Hitty.
Thank you.
minor by G.F. Handel. So Bach tried to arrange a meeting with George Handel, who was in the same era as him, but despite being only 130 kilometers apart, they never met. Caitlin Trott will also be playing Moonlight Mood by W. Gillock. Prelude in F major by J.S. Bach and Reverie by F. Mendelssohn. our for our last fact of the day, Bach's entire career was spent in an area of Germany that is smaller than most states in America. Finally, after struggling with blindness and a failed surgery on his eyes, Bach suffered a stroke and died in 1750 at the age of 65. Sometimes it is difficult not to think that he might be faking it. He suffered no disappointments, no lack of success, and had no real axe to grind. Hardly fertile ground for a romantic. Robert Schumann once described him as the Mozart of the 19th century. Mendelssohn's family came from a wealthy Jewish background. His grandfather was a famous Jewish philosopher, Moses Mendelssohn. Mendelssohn himself, well-educated and clearly erudite, was also capable of meaningful words and in several languages. When speaking shortly before his death, he said that it is a place where it is hoped to be there is still music, but no more sorrow or parting. He was only 38 when he died in 1847. At the age of 22, Mendelssohn organized and conducted a performance of Bach's St. Matthew Passion, which hadn't been performed since the composer's death in 1750. It was a huge success, and it was deemed to be the beginning of a resurgence in the interest in the great man's work, which has lasted until today. A prolific composer, Mendelssohn had his first music published when he was only 13 years old, a piano quartet, and by the age of 15, he had written his first symphony.
Thank you.
Anisha Kulkarni playing for Elise by Beethoven.
Along with for Elise, Beethoven wrote about 200 letters to his beloved, so this is one of them. What a life, as it is now, without you, pursued by the kindness of people here and there, a kindness that I think, that I wish to deserve just as little as I deserve it. Man's homage to man, that pains me. And when I consider myself in the setting of the universe, what am I and what is that man, whom one calls the greatest of men? And yet, on the other hand, therein lies the divine element in man. However much you love me, my love for you is even greater. But never conceal yourself from me. Good night. Dear God, so near, so far, is not our love truly founded in heaven? And what is more, as strongly cemented in the firmament of heaven?
Oberle playing Sonata in C major, the first movement by Mozart.
Thank you.
Chopin and The Peacock by O. Duncan.
Thank you.
kind of a tradition. Thank you so much.
Of course.
I should stand in front of you guys. Okay, so we should probably move on. Yes. You guys, it's so big. Come on over. Now we're going to go like this. Yay, we're done. Oh, my God.
Yay. Good job, everybody.
Thank you. And thank you all. I would like to thank each and every parent personally and the support that you give your children, the development of their musical skills, and how much they probably don't know.